These evening prayers have been pre-recorded, so will not be up to date with the world events, particularly those in the Middle East, but also elsewhere. We take a few moments of quiet to bring before God all those involved and affected. We pray for peace, reconciliation, and an end to violence, injustice, and inhumanity. Welcome to Evening Prayers on Thursday, the 1st of February 2024. We continue in chapter 7 of Luke's Gospel, reading tonight verses 24 to 30.
After John's messengers left, Jesus began to speak to the crowd about John. What did you go out into the wilderness to see? A reed swayed by the wind? If not, what did you go out to see? A man dressed in fine clothes? No. Those who wear expensive clothes and indulge in luxury are in palaces. But what did you go out to see? A prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet. This is the one about whom it is written, I will send my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way before you. I tell you, among those born of women, there is no one greater than John. Yet the one who is least in the kingdom of God is greater than he. All the people, even the tax collectors, when they heard Jesus' words, acknowledged that God's way was right, because they had been baptized by John. But the Pharisees and the experts in the law rejected God's purpose for themselves, because they had not been baptized by John.
John the Baptist had clearly made a big impact. All sorts of people, including even the loathed and despised tax collectors, had gone out into the desert to see him, to listen to his message of the need for repentance, and to be challenged sufficiently to be baptized by him. John had prepared the hearts of many people for the coming of Jesus. They were open to hearing this new preacher and listening to his challenging message. Salvation was available, lives were being transformed, and expectations were high. But Luke also points us to the Pharisees and experts in the law who hadn't responded to John's challenges and who found Jesus's message and radical ways conflicting with their teaching and understanding. We might read the Gospels and find ourselves critical of the Jewish leaders and their hypocrisy, but they must have found Jesus and his approach very uncomfortable and disrespectful. We can all so easily get bogged down in rules, regulations, and traditions, and risk missing out on the liberating love of God in Jesus. And yet we also need boundaries and the knowledge of right and wrong to keep us safe and living as God's children in a broken world. It's a fine line to tread, one which needs us to be close to God, listening to his voice, guided by his Holy Spirit. We need to be wise in our counsel and humble in our recognition of our need for grace and forgiveness. Let us pray that we seek to be worthy followers of the Lord.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy
Let us pray. From the prayer handbook for today, Lord Jesus Christ, wisdom and word of God, dwell in our hearts, we pray, by your most Holy Spirit, that out of the abundance of our hearts, our mouths may speak your praise. Amen. We so often miss them, those hidden treasures that you share with us. Forgive us, Lord, when we overlook the special encounters you give us, the unexpected, the beautiful, the unusual, the unlooked for. When we open our hearts and our eyes, we discover those secret places, and we praise you for remembering us, as we remember that you are Lord of all creation. Amen. Lord God, help us to be lights for your love and truth in this world where there is so much darkness. We pray for peace in this troubled world, where there is war and aggression. Praying for peace between nations, between communities, within families, within individuals. We pray for justice where there is injustice, intolerance, oppression, inequality. We pray for hope where things seem dark and hopeless, where the future looks bleak and frightening. We pray for wisdom and integrity for all who have responsibility for others. We pray for healing and wholeness where there is illness and brokenness. We pray for comfort where there is pain. We pray for joy where there is sorrow. In a moment of quiet, we bring before God those people and situations on our hearts and in our minds at this time. And remembering before God our brothers and sisters in positions of responsibility in our British Methodist Conference. For our President and Vice President, Jill Newton and Kerry Scarlett. For the Secretary and Assistant Secretary of Conference, Jonathan Hustler and Michaela Youngson. For the Conference Officer for Legal and Constitutional Practice, Joanne Anderton. For the youth president, Tom Hart. And the warden and deputy warden of the Diaconal Order, Karen McBride and Ruth Ritchie. Lord God, may your love and compassion, your truth and wisdom live within and through us as we seek to follow you day by day. Amen. And we finish with the thought-provoking hymn, In an Age of Twisted Values. See you tomorrow.
The truth we need. In sophisticated language, we have justified our greed. By our struggle for possessions, we have robbed the poor and weak. Hear our cry and heal our nation. Your forgiveness, Lord, we seek. When our families are broken, when our homes are full of strife, when our children are beaten.